things happen, but like I said, we've already extended a hand. Now he's just trying to fucking eat off my plate, and I'm like, bro, you already have a place at the table, just get your own plate. So yeah, Nick, the reason I'm telling this story is because I'm mad at Nick, right? So Nick's like, let me talk to Sydney about it. And so he comes to me while I'm doing an ASMR live. He walked in, he's like, oh, I'll tell you when you're after. So Nick walks in while I'm on live and says, hey, I need to talk to you. And I'm like, okay. So I get off live real quick and I'm like, what's going on? And he's like, so our roommate said that his phone broke and that's why he was responding. He ended up getting a ride, but he needs like $400 for a phone or whatever, and then he'll pay us back next week or something. And I was like, no, I mean, if he can get the money next week, he could just be without a phone for a week. Like, that's really not our place to save him, I guess. We've already put food, you know, on the table for him. I've given him some food just as like, hey, I know you're homeless, like, let me be nice. You know, when he initially came to stay and then when he became a permanent resident, you know, I've given him food every time I can, but he bought his own groceries, so I don't want to be like giving him food all the time when he has his own groceries. You know, overstep, I guess, because he's his own person. But anyway, and we also gave him a place to stay, and I know I'm repeating myself, but it's just like I'm trying to make sure the story is fully thorough. But you know, I felt like we did our due diligence by him, so I was like, no, we don't need to give him any money. And so Nick's like, okay, go tell him. And I'm like, what? He asked you, go tell him. And so Nick's like, I don't know how to say it. And I'm like, just articulate yourself and say it. And he's like, well, I don't speak as good as you. Like, I don't know how to explain why and stuff. And I'm like, you don't need to tell him why. It's none of his business why. Like, just tell him no. And Nick's making a whole big deal about telling him. He's like, you stop ASMR and go tell him because I'm playing the game. I'm like, I don't give a fuck, you're on the game. I'm actually doing something with my day, you know, making content, you know, hanging out with my followers. You're just playing the game, and he's your friend, your coworker, who you invited here without my permission. Because in the beginning, on Jasmine's birthday, he invited him over to stay the weekend because his girlfriend kicked him out without consulting me. And then, long story short, by the end of the weekend, he's like, yeah, I have nowhere to go after this. I'm just gonna drive off and go to Vegas, like, you know, my car. I'm just gonna go as far as I can. And we're like, put in this position. And I'm not saying it was like a pity party, because I'm fine with having an extra roommate. The extra income is okay. It helps us pay our mortgage. So like, him being here's not a problem. But he's always like, oh, I don't need handouts, I'm not asking for handouts. But it's like, okay, then go this extra week without a phone. Like, I don't know how his phone broke, I don't know what the circumstance is, but we've already been as lenient, I feel, as we should be. So it's just annoying that Nick's acting like he can't articulate that or just say no, man. So I didn't say anything to our roommate. Nick's gonna drive with him to work tomorrow, so hopefully he gives him the 411 then. But you know, if not, that's just gonna be an awkward week for them. Be like, you need to redo your hair, you need to redo. a super thick one and two thin ones because I separated the thin ones. So now I'm just gonna separate some more hair into even parts and keep braiding, keep braiding, keep braiding, keep braiding, keep braiding. So that's how you do that. Goodness gracious. My hair tonight, because I don't want